Hello everybody, my name is Christopher at WebPros and I'm here to go over cPanel Elevate. cPanel Elevate is a script that has been developed by cPanel based on the AlmaLinux Elevate script. This one's specific to cPanel and it is designed to help those of you on CentOS 7 move to AlmaLinux 8 or Cloud Linux 7 move to Cloud Linux 8 to get off of servers that are end of life. For the purposes of today, we will be utilizing cpanel.github.io/elevate, which is where you can find the documentation and all of the scripts necessary to make this happen. So I highly recommend you move over to that and look along with me, and make sure you utilize this while you are going through the Elevate process. There is a lot of information here on the documentation that I recommend you go through and read before you start to do this. However, we're just going to be going through the process today. The first thing you need is access to the terminal for that server, probably through SSH, and make sure that you have the root access to this. The next thing I want to make sure you understand is that we highly, highly recommend you back up your server. One more time. Backup your server. Elevate does not have a system in place that if you're halfway through, you can revert back to where you started. The only way that can happen is by using your backups or snapshots. So make sure you back up your servers before we go into this process. Now, a few notes for while this is happening. Your server will be down during all of this. So make sure any people you have or clients that you have on your server are aware that you will be going through downtime. We also want to let you know that there might be blockers that pop up. And in our documentation, we have a whole blockers section to help you if you see that. Scrolling down, we're going to now see how to use the script. We have provided easy copy code sections that allow you to copy the code for the scripts and paste them over into your terminal so that you can get your server ready to go. Let's head over to the server I'll be using for this demo. You can see that it's starting on CentOS 7, which means my goal is to get over to AlmaLinux 8 for my operating system. Now I'm going to jump back to that documentation because the first thing we need to do is install the script or download it. So I'm going to go ahead and hit this copy code button and then head back over to my terminal. On my terminal, I'm going to run this script and what it's going to do is download the script, make sure it's in the right places, and then here you can tell it makes it so I can actually run the script by changing the permissions. So now that that's installed, I'm going to go back to our documentation. And we're going to run a check. Our Elevate script has in place a check to let you know if your system is ready to upgrade. It'll throw any warnings at you that it has and give you tips on how to fix that. So I'm going to grab this code and head back to our terminal and paste it into here. What it's going to start doing is doing the checks, and you can already see these yellow signs flashing up for the warnings, which means I have a couple things I need to look at. One warning says that I have to update MySQL because the current version isn't going to work for AlmaLinux. And then I have another one that I'm going to address first, and that is that my cPanel is not up to date. So let's go ahead and update that. To update it, I'm just going to run the normal script for updating cPanel, and that's going to be scripts/upcp. And when I run this, it's going to run the update. Let's check back in after I've completed that. So you can see here that I've completed my upcp. I should have an up-to-date version of cPanel ready to go. Let's run our Elevate check again to see if any other warnings pop up. Okay, the cPanel warning didn't, but I still have this MySQL needs to be updated. Luckily, it does provide me with a script that I can use to make that happen that you can see here. I'm going to copy this script and utilize it. Now you'll notice that it doesn't have a running log of the update happening. It's happening in the background. So give it 5 to 10 minutes and then check back in to see if the upgrade has been completed. I've given it some time coming back in and let's check one more time to see if we are ready to go. So I use that check and No warnings. It is ready to go, and you can see that Elevate has provided me with the script for the next step. You can go back to the documentation and get that, but right now I'm just going to copy and paste the script. Then you can see it's going to run through a bunch of stuff that you can watch as you choose, but then it's going to give me a warning. It's going to say you are ready to go, but it's going to let you know this is going to do multiple reboots. It's going to take 30 minutes. It could take up to an hour. I've seen it do that. You are going to have the ability to check to see how it's doing by progress, which I'll show you in a second. But this is the last time that you have that you can back up your server. So please, if you have not done so, do it now. When you're ready to go, hit Y and it'll begin. You will see the log running while you're doing this. Don't interrupt what's going on. You'll also get disconnected a few times from the server. That is to be expected because it's going to be running reboots. If you're wondering where it is in the process, try logging in, and if you have access, then it is running. If you don't, it is currently rebooting. While that's running, let's jump back over to the documentation so I can point out a few helpful things. So we've already seen a few of these commands, the check command, the start command, we've done that. However, we have a few other things that we can utilize while the system is running. Expect multiple reboots. Again, I said 30 minutes to an hour. But if I log in on my server and I'm curious about where it's at, I can use the status flag to see what's going on. So I'm going to go back to my terminal. And you can see I've logged in. This is after a restart, and it is still telling me Elevate is in progress. And it also gives me the scripts that I can use right here on the screen. Let's grab this status one and put it in and see what comes up. So now the status is telling me I'm at running stage 3 out of 5. So I'm about halfway there. I can choose to run the log to see exactly what's going on if you want to watch that happening. For this case, I'm going to walk away, let Elevate do its thing, and come back in about 30 minutes to an hour to check to see what its status is. It's been about 45 minutes to an hour, so I am back and I am in my terminal on the server. The server is obviously up and not doing a restart, so let's check what its status is. I'm going to run the status flag again for the Elevate, and success! Elevate is completed. Let's double check that we are on our new OS. AlmaLinux version 8, we are good to go. Let's zoom out here so you can get a good view of the log. I'm going to run the Elevate script with the log flag so that you can see what happens at the end of the whole process. Now, it shows you all sorts of good information like, hey, this was done, but it also gives you recommendations for you to go through after you have run your Elevate. And it gives you instructions on how to do a lot of those. So I highly recommend running the log after you are complete so that you can finish up the little odds and ends that Elevate recommends for you. And that's cPanel Elevate. By utilizing this script, your server should now be on an operating system that is actively being supported by cPanel since it is no longer end of life. If you encounter any issues, feel free to reach out to our tech support for help and make sure to reference our documentation. Thanks and have a good day.